Hey everyone, it's Jamie and welcome back to my channel. We are doing another Halloween inspired build. Today we are doing the Sanderson Sister House from Hocus Pocus. I don't know about you guys, but I love Hocus Pocus. I don't think there really is anyone who doesn't love Hocus Pocus. It has become a huge cult classic, especially around Halloween. It's like popular around like so many different like crowds of people, from like drag queens to just people who love scary movies and Halloween, to also just, you know, like casual Halloween people too. It's like, it's so great. I don't know about you guys. Before we get a little bit more into this, there is a little disclaimer. There aren't a lot of good pictures of this house. I don't even think this house really exists. I feel like it may have been green screened or something. So there was kind of an issue where coming up with this, I was really relying on like one or two images, sometimes some like little recreation decorations that you can buy on some like bad websites. You know, just trying to get a good feel for what it could be. As well as I do make the water wheel. I believe that's what you call it. It's like for the water mill that was attached to the house. However, I have a theory about that little water mill thing. I feel like it was a second thought because you only see it in the beginning of the movie. You never see it again. There's no indication that the house is near a river beyond the beginning of the movie. I just feel like it was probably used as like a plot device and that was kind of forgotten about, maybe thrown in later into the script or something, maybe trying to be like, oh, there's got to be a good reason why, or a good way for Thackeray Binks to get into the house. I don't know. Anyways, like I said, I have this theory that it was very last minute, kind of forgotten about. As well as, if, since the house doesn't have a lot of good images, and there's not really a lot of good shots of it in the house, other than in the beginning, and then maybe a few scenes here and there, I feel like the house was a set piece or something. So a lot of this is kind of me making it up as I go, being like, what do I think this house could look like? This era of architecture is not my strong point either. So there was a lot of me just trying to figure out as I go, but I did have a lot of fun making it. It is up on the gallery for download. It's under my username, Jamie Horne, one word, JAYMEHORNE, and I just call it like the Sanderson Sister House. And you know, just like I said, I love this movie, so I wanted to do it, and plus it gave me an excuse to do something a little Halloween-y themed, as well as giving me an excuse to talk a little bit more about Hocus Pocus. So, if you didn't know this, when the film first came out, it actually received a lot of negative reviews from critics. Definitely over time, its reception has grown and it's super popular now. And you know, it's like a huge cult classic film. I think a lot of cult classic films also tend not to be that great. And Hocus Pocus, as much as I love it, it does have some like plot issues, some weird storytelling aspects, but overall I still think it's like one of the best movies ever. On Rotten Tomatoes there's lots of different reviews from different, you know, times. One review read, harmlessly hokey yet never too much more than mediocre, Hocus Pocus is a muddled family-friendly effort that fails to live up to the talents of its impressive cast. I feel like that maybe not be a completely unfair analysis, but I don't really agree with it because I still think it's a great film. But it's one of those things where like I recognize it's not, it's definitely very campy. And if you don't like campy, especially if you don't like campy horror, then you probably aren't gonna enjoy it. As well as, there's like some other really funny, or not funny, but some really interesting reviews from when the movie came out. Because actually when it first came out, it actually like bombed its first weekend at the box office. And over time, it's really just grown into this cult classic. The Chicago Tribune remarked that the film was a dreadful witches comedy with only tolerable moments coming from Bette Miller. And yikes. The Chicago Tribune also really liked, from what the review I read, apparently they really enjoyed the musical number, which I think is like one of the more campier moments of the film. So I think that was funny that they really enjoyed the big musical number at City Hall when they sing "I Put a Spell on You." The Chicago Sun-Times gave the star 1 out of 4 stars, writing that it's a confusing cauldron in which there is great activity but little progress and a lot of hysterical shrieking. The Miami Herald went on to call it a pretty lackluster affair, and despite the triple threat actress combo, Hocus Pocus won't be the sister act of 1993. There's a lot of gotta see movies this summer, and this isn't one of them. Which, once again, very funny to me, because, like, now, like, when it comes on around Halloween time, I feel like everyone's like, ooh, gotta watch Hocus Pocus, especially now where, it's Freeform. I almost called it the ABC Family, if they haven't been ABC Family in a few years now. But yeah, when they do their 31 Nights of Halloween, this year's particular, they're showing it like almost every night. I think they said they're throwing 30 days out of the 31 days in October, which is really funny to me. But yeah, like, who knows, like, from what I hear a lot of people say, when the movie came out, they didn't think it was going to be a success. So, you know, I think that a lot of cult classic films also, they underperform and then later have a resurgence, or a lot of people love it. Entertainment Weekly gave the film a C-, calling it acceptable, scary, silly kid fodder that adults will only find mildly insulting unless they're Bette Midler fans, in which the case, it's depressing as hell. So, yikey nikes. Yeah, it underperformed its opening weekend. It came in 4th place, though, so I don't think that's too bad, but I believe it came out the same day as Free Willy. The unusual summer release of Hocus Pocus is said to be due to Disney not wanting to compete with their other Halloween themed film coming out that year, The Nightmare Before Christmas, which was due in October. Which is really funny, because that was technically released under Touchstone Films, which I believe at the time was owned by Disney. Disney, like, I feel like people talk about now, but like, Disney owning everything. I'm like, Disney's always owned everything. Just how it goes. But yeah, so over the years, through various outlets, such, like I said, is Freeform's 31 Nights of Halloween, lots of different DVD re-releases, and other, you know, just like different channels really playing up the movie. Over the years, this movie has grown into like the cult classic it is now, and is like totally adored and like seen as like a great film, like as it deserves to be. In 2018, the film reached its, came to its 25th anniversary. The first week of Hocus Pocus viewing on Freeform average of 8.2 million viewers. So yeah, for its 25th anniversary, they had like a little bash at the Hollywood Forever Cemetery, which I think they're going to do every year now, because they did Freeform, that is. This year they also did something at the Hollywood Forever Cemetery, so I feel like that's something they're gonna keep doing, which, I mean, I feel like it works, it's fun. Yeah, and then like the whole cast went, for those who are still alive, because some of them have kicked the bucket, sadly. Anyway, so Another thing also is like, so if you go to Salem, so I live in Massachusetts. I don't live far from Salem. I love going to Salem, Massachusetts, especially around Halloween. It's so fun. It's definitely interesting to see how they've really capitalized off of the Salem witch trials, which some people find problematic. Some people are like, eh, it's fine. It's their history. I'm not really here to discuss whether or not it's problematic, but I will say it is super fun to go and check that out every year. But also they, since Hocus Pocus takes place in Salem, every year people dress up as the Sanderson sisters. I believe there might be even, I don't think the town pays for it, but there's definitely like paid actors who come out and, you know, they walk around the streets, people take photos with them, so it's like a very big thing. Which is also really funny to me, because to me it's very obvious that the movie has scenes that do not take place in Salem. I do think parts of it was filmed in Salem. I don't know how much of it, but there's some scenes I look at and I'm like, yeah, that is, I do not think that is Salem. To be fair, I don't live in Salem, and I don't, usually when I go there, I do kind of stay more in the, I don't see the touristy spots, but I definitely stay more in kind of, like, the morally, the better traveled parts of the town, because I don't really want to go wandering off, and get lost. But it is very interesting to me how this movie was, like, when I first heard it was a, like, it didn't do well upon release, I, like, didn't believe it, because I'm like, what? Like, who doesn't love Hocus Pocus? It's, like, one of the best movies ever. But, you know, like I said, that's a very common thing with cult classics. But, you know, like I said, I love this movie. And when I was thinking of other things I wanted to do for Halloween on my channel, that's one of the first things I thought of was, ooh, why don't I do the Sanderson Sister House? And very quickly I realized, ooh, this is not going to be super easy, just because there aren't a lot of images, and there's so many interpretations out there of what it could look like, so I was kind of just rolling with it. This house also only has two bedrooms. If you want to make the Sanderson sisters and move them in, I say go for it. You can probably turn one of the bedrooms into a two-person bedroom. I definitely believe Winifred would have had her own room and would have made her two sisters share a room. or if you really, really want to give them all their rooms, you could probably change up the floor plan upstairs or maybe even downstairs. Like, this dining room could maybe be turned into another bedroom if you wanted. I liked the idea of having a formal dining room, especially since I was dedicating so much of this, like, living room space, into, like, this little magical, witchy, brewy place. You see up here, I really tried so hard to create that little, what you call it, a mezzanine? I don't know what you would call it in a house, but, that little thing that, looks up above the first floor, but isn't really attached to the rest of the second floor. Because I was really thinking, in the beginning of the movie, when, Thackeray climbs in, he climbs through the window up there, and then Max stands up there to set off the fire alarm. So I was like, I definitely gotta add that. It definitely is not gonna be accessible to any Sims, but, like, visually it needs to be there. And I'm putting down all these cobwebs, you know, because the house, when it's, seen later in the movie, it's definitely fallen into decay. It's not as well kept because it was a museum and the museum is closed now. So my idea is I'd really want to make this house a little, not the light witch houses I've have been making a lot of 19th century kind of manors, especially for this world. So I definitely wanted to do something maybe a little creepier. I will admit there's a lot of Victorian furniture and aesthetics from vampires in here, which is like the completely wrong century for this house, but we don't really have anything that really would have worked for like 1600s, unless I wanted to use like wooden benches, but no. So I definitely, if you're looking for a more realistic play of the Sanderson sisters, I don't know if the furniture might work for you. You could also just tell yourself the house has maybe been updated over the years. I did really want to slip in more Realm of Magic items because, you know, it's gonna be in it's in Glimmerbrook. That's why I used the Realm of Magic what's it called? The Realm of Magic fireplace, even though it's like it probably doesn't really fit the creepy aesthetic I was going for, as well as I was really using the Realm of Magic bookcases. I put down some brooms, I put down the beds, some carpeting. I do think a lot of the stuff from Vampires very well, so I did like that. So I could mix and match and try to get like, ooh, it's a little creepy in some areas, maybe creepy in others. But, you know, I had a lot of fun building it. I don't know if it's like one of my best builds, but I did have fun. I do think it was, and I just think it's a fun build. And I do think you can definitely use it even if you're not making like Sanders and Sister Sims. It's definitely completely usable. It might be a little weird playing in it just because it is so specific. I don't know. And I was thinking, I'm not sure if this is gonna go in my save file that I've been working on forever for, but if it does end up on, I don't think I would keep the little river pond thing I put next to it that I'm doing now. I put it here solely because I felt like if I'm gonna do the Sanderson sister house, I have to add it, but I don't really like it. Mostly just because I did put this build near a river, and it just doesn't work, and it's, I don't think it looks bad. I just, for me personally, I don't know if I really like it. It does use up the space in the yard, which really just would have been more trees, maybe some like witchy items. But here I'm building the water mill, and I really just I got that from Cats and Dogs, and I sized it up and kind of raised it, and then I used that little, I don't even know what you call that. I cut out building that like a lot of it because it ends up getting covered up, as you see. That item there, I believe, is from Perfect Patio Stuff. I'm not sure. But anyways, we're about to get into the screenshots. So thank you so much. Have a happy Halloween, and I'll see you in my next Halloween-themed video.
I put a spell on you. And now you're mine. You can't stop the things I do. I ain't lying.
No! No! Don't listen to them!
Been 300 years, right down to the day. Now the witch is back, and there's hell to pay. I put a spell on you.
Good joke. Happy Halloween. Thanks a lot.
No, man, I'm serious.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
You got your head in your hand.
You're not kidding. Come on.
Great show.
Cover your ears.
I put a spell on you.
Oh, I wish we had the camera.